Hi gang, I'm glad you're all here. I really appreciate you joining me today. Yesterday, USGS put out a video and some information about renewed activity at the Three Sisters there in Oregon. They put out a video featuring Dan Derishan talking about the recent activity at the Three Sisters. The video was actually made last year, 2021. When he and a colleague were installing GPS stations just west of the South Three Sisters. Those at the Cascadia Volcano Watch Center feel this may be an aha moment. You all know that small eruptions of volcanoes, I've talked about it before, can often happen with no warning at all. And they are concerned that there could be a volcanic eruption there at the Three Sisters without any warning. The last few months, there's been almost 4 inches of uplift with very few earthquakes. He briefly touches on how volcanic eruptions can occur without any earthquakes, and this process has not been documented. So they really don't know what's going to happen there at the Three Sisters, but they're watching it. At least the best they can until summer arrives and the snow is gone and they can go back up and put up some more GPS stations. What makes the recent activity so significant is that the uplift is over a 10-mile area, a very large area, in their words. They just don't know where the next eruption will occur. A lot of the eruptions there at the Three Sisters, most of them have been basalt. But the Tamalo Volcanic Center, that past eruption was of rhyolite. Predicting where the next eruption will be, they say, is going to be complicated. Just to the north is Belknap Volcanic Field, where basalt lava erupted as lava flows about 1,500 years ago. In this area of Tamalo, it erupted around 2,000 to 2,200 years ago, and these were rhyolite eruptions. So Belknap is up over here to the north of the Three Sisters, and USGS says it's not likely the Belknap itself will erupt again in this location, but eruptions similar to the type that formed Belknap could occur anywhere in the surrounding area. Such eruptions could sever major highways that cross this region of the Cascades, US 20, Oregon Highway 22, and 242. Tepa from such eruptions could affect nearby communities, especially to the east in central Oregon. So let's bring this out a little bit. So here is drawn out about 10 miles of uplift. Let me move this over. See, can I move it? There you go. Magma has pooled, has risen up, and is about 3 to 4 miles below the surface of the volcano. Between the 1990s and 2020, uplift was about 20 inches. It was rising then about 2 inches a year. And then it stopped. I don't know how they figured it. It stopped. We got some time here where it wasn't being recorded. And now they're saying it's rising distinctly faster than it was observed before the year 2020. And the geologists are saying that it has them baffled that there is so much uplift because they are not getting earthquakes that they would expect to precede, to indicate that magma was coming into the system. No earthquakes whatsoever. There was one small earthquake swarm in the past, but they don't think that that earthquake swarm had anything to do with the recent magma that's coming into the caldera chamber there at, 3 to 4 miles below the surface. You know, and they keep telling the public, oh, don't worry, we're going to have lots of warning. We're going to have earthquakes and we're going to have uplift. Well, they got the uplift without the earthquakes at a depth of roughly 3 miles. No earthquakes like they expected. A aha moment, they're calling it. They are still saying, well, any magmatic intrusion could eventually lead to a volcanic eruption. An eruption would likely be preceded by detectable and more vigorous earthquakes, ground movement, deformation, and geochemical changes. Well, I don't think they're up there right now testing the gases. That has been the biggest problem with USGS and not taking live gas readings 24 hours a day. While they may be getting uplift here, mostly at the South Three Sisters area, magma likes to erupt or come up to the location where there's possibly the weakest area in the Earth's crust. An example, they did not expect Mount St. Helens to blow out the whole side of the mountain. SciTech Daily has an image of areas of uplift. I don't know how old these images are. When was the last time they did a satellite flyover? This image, I believe, is from August of last year. The last time they had any small earthquake swarm was in October of last year, 2021. And since then, they've had 4 inches, almost 4 inches of uplift, with very, very few earthquakes, and most of them are outside of the area. Between June of 2020 and August 2021, there was only 1 inch of uplift. And they'll say there's nothing to worry about, but yet they're putting the information out that there is renewed activity, letting you know just in case. I mean, the activity has been going on for 25 years, they've been saying. And there's definitely been an uptick in volcanic eruptions without any warning whatsoever around the world. So we'll just have to wait and see. And you should be prepared. I mean, look how close Bend is. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Don't forget to put a comment down there, just hello or whatever. I got notice from YouTube that they're going to start unsubscribing people again. Thank you again. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.